Yes, so far in this module, we have looked at lattice theoretic modeling of data flow values and how they can be over approximated, how we can create sound over approximation of data flow values. We have also seen the flow functions that compute data flow values. Now, we want to characterize the overall solutions of data flow values. We call these solutions as assignments, and there are two particular kind of assignments that we wish to look at, the MOP assignment and the MFP assignment, and we will talk about their existence and computability and soundness. So what is an assignment? An assignment A associates data flow values with a program point. So an assignment is a mapping from program points to data flow values. And since we already have a partial order relation between data flow values, we can also define a partial order relation between assignments. And we say an assignment A is weaker than an assignment B if for all program points P, A of P is weaker than B of P. What that means is the data flow value at program point P in assignment A is weaker than the data flow value at program point P in assignment B. With this notion, now we can define what is the meaning of performing data flow analysis. We are given a set of flow functions, a lattice and a merge operation, and a control flow graph or a program flow graph with a mapping from nodes to flow functions. So we know the flow function corresponding to each node, and then we want to find out an assignment which is as large as possible and is also sound, where this large is defined in terms of this weaker than relationship that we have already seen in the first few lectures of this module. So here is an example of some assignments for available expressions analysis. We have a small program. It has two expressions, A star B, B star C. We consider a bit vector of two bits. The first bit represents A star B. The second bit represents B star C. And we talk about four program points, in one, out one, in two, and out two. And we can associate any value with these program points. Some of these combinations may not be acceptable, and that's what we wish to look at, but in principle this is also an assignment. So associate 1 1 with all the program points, meaning say that the expression, both the expressions are available at every program point. That is an assignment. Here is another assignment which says at the entry no expression is available, whereas at the remaining three program points, all the three expressions are available. Recall that this is a solution that we would like to compute. But then there is another assignment which is possible, which says that no expression is available anywhere. Then there is another assignment which says that no expression is available at the start, but both the expressions are available at the exit of node 1, and none of the expressions are available at the exit of node 2. Note that this is an assignment that we may not be able to compute for this particular control flow graph. So the idea is an assignment is a mapping of data flow values. An assignment is an association of data flow values with each program point, and this association can absolutely be arbitrary. And then we have to talk about which of these associations are acceptable to us, which of these associations are useful. So we can look at this lattice of data flow values, and we can then create a lattice of assignments. So for available expressions analysis, we have this lattice where 1 1 is the top element for two expressions, 1 0 and 0 1 are incomparable and weaker than 1 1, and 0 0 is weaker than everyone else. With this in mind, we get the following lattice of assignment. Note that assignment A0 is the top value because A0 associates 1, 1, 1. Any other assignment will have to be weaker than A0 because every value is weaker than 1, 1. So we have A0 as the top assignment and A2 is the bottom assignment. Note that we have this A2 which is the bottom assignment. Okay, so we have A2, which is the bottom assignment, and then we have A3. A2, why is A2 a bottom assignment? A2 is a bottom assignment because we are associating 0, 0 values here. So here now we have this lattice where A1 is weaker than A2, but A5 is weaker than A1. So why is A5 weaker than A1? Because this here, the values are comparable. Here also the values are comparable. Here the values are comparable, but A5 has lower values. Here also at out of 2, 4 values are comparable, but A5 has lower values. So therefore A5 is weaker than A1. Similarly, I leave it for you to figure out why A4 and A5 are incomparable and why A5 and A6 are incomparable. So we can create a lattice of assignments like this. The interesting thing is that with this lattice, now we can talk about what kind of assignments do we want. So the first assignment that we define is a meet over paths assignment, which is the largest safe approximation of the abstract information reaching a program point along all control flow paths. So we define MOP at program point P as a meet of all paths. So we consider all paths. The paths P denotes the set of paths reaching program point P, and we consider a path rho along with it, and F rho denotes the composition of flow functions along rho, and BI is the boundary information. And when we compute, when we apply this flow function to each path, when we apply this flow function of each path to boundary information and take a meet over all paths, this is called a meet over paths solution. Note that in this case, all control flow paths are considered potentially executable by ignoring the result of conditionals. There's another way of defining meet, where meet is weaker than alpha of S of P. What is S of P? S of P is a set of states reaching P along all traces. So we have the set of states reaching along all traces, and then we create an abstraction function of those set of states, and MOP is weaker than alpha of the set of states. And why is it weaker? Why is it not equal? The reason is control flow paths are considered potentially executable and they over approximate all execution traces. So here abstraction is about all execution traces, all paths that are only executable, whereas in the meet we are considering also the paths that may not be executable, but we do not know that because we are doing a static over approximation of control of execution paths by control flow paths that ignore the conditions appearing in the paths. So it's easy to see, because this is an abstraction function of this, any value that is weaker than alpha of this will be sound, because this is the most precise sound value. And therefore any assignment info such that info of P is weaker than MOPP is safe, because it over approximates all behaviors in the states reaching program point P. What does it mean is info P is weaker than MOP of P. It implies, note that these are abstract values, we can concretize them. So when we concretize, when we apply gamma function to info of P, we get a superset of the result that we would get when we apply gamma function to MOPP. And because we get a superset, it means that info P contains all behaviors contained in the states reaching the program point P. So now here is our recipe. We want to compute an assignment that is weaker than MOP. And when I say weaker, please note we say it's not a strictly weaker, it's weaker than or equal to MOP. MOP is meet over all paths. We want to capture behavior along all paths reaching a program point. We don't want anything more than that. We don't want the behavior that is not reachable along any program point. So we want a sound over approximation of the behaviors reaching a program point along every path. And that's why such a solution is called an MOP assignment, meet over paths assignment, whereby paths, we mean control flow paths. We have an alternative assignment called maximum fixed point assignment, also known as MFP assignment. Now, why do we want to talk about MFP assignment? We want to talk about MFP assignment because computing MOP assignment has some difficulties. What are the difficulties? MOP assignment says compose flow functions along every path. What if there are infinitely many paths? So in particular, in presence of cycles, there are infinitely many paths. If we need to traverse all paths, it leads to undecidability. So computing MOP solution in general is undecidable. What does undecidability mean here? We mean that there does not exist any algorithm that will compute MOP assignment for every instance of every data flow analysis. There would always be some data flow analysis and some control flow path for which we will not be able to compute a precise answer, where by a precise answer we mean MOP assignment. So undecidability is one issue. Note that in some cases the problems are decidable, computing MOP assignment is decidable, and we will see that later, but in general computation of MOP assignment is undecidable. Now even if the program is acyclic, every condition multiplies the number of paths by 2. For example, here we have one path coming in here, that becomes two paths going down. Here we have one path coming in here, that becomes another two paths going down. So if we have a node here which is a successor of both these nodes, then at this node we have two paths reaching. Now here we will have four paths reaching. Or here we have two paths reaching and here we have four paths reaching. So if all paths need to be traversed, that leads to intractability. So therefore, one alternative is, to merge information at the intermediate program points instead of computing information of each path separately. Instead of computing a path sensitive solution, we can compute a flow sensitive solution. We have already seen that merging is safe, but it may lead to imprecision. And this merging is what computes fixed point solutions of the data flow equations. So when we talk about computing MOP assignment, we are talking about path-based specification. When we talk about MFP assignment, we talk about edge-based specification, because the data flow value at a program point is computed from its neighboring, from the data flow value of its neighboring program point. Let's see the difference between the two. So here we have a program and these are the flow functions associated with the program points F1, F2, F3, F4, F5. These are the flow functions. We want to see the expression tree for MFP and expression tree for MOP. And we are talking about this particular program point. We want to find out the expression tree for computing the data flow value at the exit of node 4. So in case of MFP, we say we apply F4 to the meet of F2 and F3. So entry of this is computed by out of this. So this is the meet of what is computed by applying F2 to F1 and F3 to F1 and F3 back to itself. So this is essentially the entry, the exit of 2, this is the value at the exit of 3, which is computed from the entry of 3, which is computed from the entry of exit of 1 and exit of 3. So exit of 3 value is computed in terms of exit of 3, and we keep merging at every join point. By contrast, if we were to compute MOP, observe that this is one path from F1, F2, F3, from 1 to 4 is one path. So from 1 to 4 is one path, then 1, 3, 4 is another path. So 1, 3, 4 is another path. Now 1, 3, another 3 and 4 is another path. So 1, 3, 1, 3, another 3 and 4 is another path. Similarly 1, 3, 3, another 3 and 4 is another path. So MOP would compute this. Note that here the meet is happening at the program point of interest. It is not happening at any intermediate point, whereas in case of MFP, meet is happening at every join point. So entry of F4 is a join point, so there is a meet. Then entry of F2 is a join point because two paths merge there. So therefore there is a meet here. This is also entry of F2. So meet is happening, merge is happening at the intermediate shared program points in MFP, but not in MOP. And because we are merging at intermediate program points, we get a weaker value, and we know that it's a sound over approximation, but it may be imprecise because it is an over approximation. So that's the difference between MFP and MOP. So let's get back to our example of constant propagation. The MOP solution was this. We wanted to say that C here at the exit of N2 is 3 and D is 2 because C is A plus B. Doesn't matter whether A is 1 and B is 2 or A is 2 and B is 1. C continues to be 3. Similarly, D is equal to the product of 1 and 2. Doesn't matter whether A and B values are swapped. So this is our MOP assignment. However, what our algorithm actually computes is an MFP assignment, and therefore we get all these bottoms. Because we compute the value of C not differently along different paths, but from the merged values at the entry of N2, and when we merge A is equal to 1 with A is equal to 2, we get A is bottom. When we merge B is equal to 2 with B is equal to 1 coming from these two paths here, we get that as bottom. And therefore when we compute C from bottom plus bottom, we get a bottom, and similarly for D we get a bottom value. So we can create a lattice of all possible assignments. So this is a lattice of all possible assignments, and these are all safe assignments or all sound assignments, and we have all fixed point solutions. Every assignment need not be a fixed point, we have already seen that. And this is a trivial assignment. For each in I, the value is top. And this is again a trivial assignment. For each in I, the value is bottom. And this is the meet over paths assignment, because all these pink assignments are the sound assignments, and meet over paths is the largest sound assignment. Any subset of it is also sound. And this is the maximum fixed point assignment. So maximum, so these are all blue things are fixed points, and all fixed points are safe, all fixed points are sound, and we will prove that going forward. But all fixed points are a sound over approximation of meet over paths. In some situations MOP and MFP may coincide, in some situations they may not. So constant propagation is an example where MFP and MOP do not coincide, and this is the least fixed point. So let's look at an instance of available expressions analysis, and let's talk about all possible assignments and all an instance of this. What are the flow functions? So we have given some names to these flow functions. This f top returns the top value, f bottom returns the bottom value. F A returns A star B, F B returns B star C, F ID returns X, it's an identity flow function. F C is some function which adds A star B to X, F D is some function which adds B star C to X, and F E is some function which removes A star B from X, and FF is some function which removes B star C from X. As you can see, this is the function space. You can't think of any function other than these for this particular instance, and this is our lattice. So the question is the lattice a meet semi-lattice? The answer is yes, because meet operation is defined for all possible values. What is the meet operation that computes GLB? In this case, it is intersection. Are all strictly descending chains finite? So yes, descending chains have length of 2. Does the function space have an identity function? So yes, there is an identity function. Are all values in the lattice computable from a finite merge of flow functions? So yes, it is. So we know that this is an acceptable function space for available expressions analysis. Is the function space closed under composition? If we compose any two functions, we will find that it is equal to some other function in this space, and the function space is indeed closed under composition. So we can now talk about different assignments with this function space. So with node 1, we have associated function f top. Why we have associated f top? Because here both a star b and b star c become available. And with node 2, we have associated function id, because whatever is the in, that value is copied to out, because no expression is generated within the node, nor is any expression killed within the node. And here are the assignments that we had seen earlier. We had seen some examples of some of these assignments earlier. So we now examine these assignments more carefully. Observe that this is the maximum fixed point assignment. We start with boundary information 0, 0, and then the values are 1, 1. So initialization for round robin iterative method is 1, and this is a sound assignment. Assignment 2, note that this is not a fixed point assignment. Why is it not a fixed point assignment? Because if we were to recompute the data flow values, we are not going to get the same data flow values. In particular, if we start with this and recompute data flow values, out of 1 will change to 1, 1, because the flow function associated with is f top. So even if the entry is 0, 0, this will become 1, 1, this will become 1, 1, and this. So depending upon the initialization, this will become 1, 1, but regardless of the initialization, this will change. So this is not a fixed point assignment. This is not something where our round robin iterative algorithm will terminate, but it is an assignment, and it is a sound assignment because it is weaker than MOP. In fact, it is weaker than MFP, and MFP is weaker than MOP. So any assignment that is weaker than MFP is sound, although it may not be an FP, it may not be a fixed point. Assignment A3 is interesting. It is a fixed point assignment with the initialization 0, 0 for round robin iterative analysis. I leave it for you to figure out that with the initialization 0, 0, we get this value. Because the initialization is 0, 0, initialization is the bottom value, we get the minimum fixed point. When the initialization is the top value, we get the maximum fixed point. When initialization is something else, we still get a fixed point, but it may not be maximum fixed point or it may not be minimum fixed point. Note that with 0, 0 as the initialization, if we recompute the data flow values, we will get 1, 1 here. And now, because initialization is 0, 0, this is 0, 0, so we have 0, 0 coming in from here, and we have 1, 1 coming in from here, so that remains 0, 0. So this remains 0, 0, and this remains 0, 0. So this doesn't change any further, even no matter how many times we iterate over it. So this is a fixed point assignment, and because this is weaker than the maximum fixed point assignment, this is also a sound assignment. This is an interesting assignment. This is also a fixed point assignment, assuming that the initialization is 1, 0. So if the initialization is 1, 0, the first repeated calculation of this is going to give us 0, 0 here and 1, 1 here. And because out of 2 is 1, 0, the meet of 1, 1 and 1, 0 is going to give us 1, 0. So therefore, we get 1, 0 here and 1, 0 here. So this is a fixed point assignment, but this is neither the maximum fixed point assignment nor the minimum fixed point assignment, but it is sound because it is weaker than MFP, and hence it is also weaker than MOP. This is again a fixed point assignment with the initialization changed to 0, 1. And this is not a fixed point assignment. This is not a fixed point assignment. If we recompute this, no matter what the initialization is, if the initialization is 0, 0, we are going to get 0, 0 here. So things will change. If the initialization is 1, 1, we are going to get 1, 1 here. If the initialization is 0, 1, then this remains 0, 1, but here we are going to get 0, 1. If the initialization is 1, 0, then we are going to get 1, 0 here. So this is another example of an assignment which is sound, but this is not a fixed point assignment. So you can go back to this picture once again to see that there are several assignments that are sound but may not be fixed point assignment. However, every fixed point assignment is sound. So having seen some examples of these assignments, here I have added the trivial assignment all ones here. So we recall that we have this lattice of data flow values. Note that this all possible values are because there are four program points, and at each program point four values are possible. There are 256 all possible assignments. We have shown only some of them. Based on our discussion earlier, this is the lattice of assignments, some assignments that we have chosen, and all these assignments are sound. A0 is not sound because this value is not weaker than the boundary info, which is 1, 1. Everything else is a sound assignment. However, among the sound assignments, we have only these as fixed point assignments. In particular, A6 is not a fixed point assignment. So we have seen examples of assignments. We have seen examples of meet over path assignments. We have seen examples of fixed point assignments. We have seen examples of fixed point assignments that are maximum fixed point. We have seen examples of fixed point assignments that are minimum fixed point, and we have seen examples of assignments that are not even a fixed point, but they are